Are you looking for the best task management app for your needs? Maybe you've considered either Todoist or Notion. They're both really popular and powerful apps that can keep you on top of your tasks and projects. I've reviewed Todoist versus Notion a while back in 2023, and since then, both Notion and Todoist has improved significantly, and there's so many new features. In this video, I'll be doing a comparison between the two apps so that you can figure out what tool is best for your needs. If you find this video useful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. Let's first start with a brief overview of both Notion and Todoist as task management apps. So by itself, when you first start Notion, you're not going to have a pre-built task management system already laid out for you in the way that a traditional task management app would have. Notion is designed so that you can easily create your own systems and mold it to your own needs, which means that you'll have this blank page here where you can do anything you want with it. Here, Notion has improved a lot. If you click databases, you can now add a task database really easily and kind of customize it before adding it to your workspace like this. That's the first step if you want to use Notion as a task management system, is you'll likely want to just create a task tracking database. Next, if we go to Todoist, you can see that it is a very structured layout. You can't really change many things. At the same time, it makes things really easy to understand and use. So if you want to add a task, you just click here and it's already built out as a task management system. I can type something like water the garden and already I have day priority reminders and all of these things, and then add task and it goes to my inbox, which I can then categorize into different projects and folders. You can do the same thing in Notion, but it's just that you will have to build out something a bit more complicated to get to that point. In that sense, out of the box, Todoist is pretty simple to use. Next, let's go over different views that you can have for your tasks. Views for tasks are an important part of task management, and with Notion, you really get a versatile format for this. So let's say that I'm in my tasks tracker database. I can go to the three dots here and change the layout to anything from table, board, timeline, calendar, list, gallery, and charts. You can really see your tasks in the way that works best for you, and there's less limitations on how you can see your tasks, how you can move things around, and the way that it looks in general is very customizable with Notion. On the other hand, if we go to Todoist, you'll notice that if I go to view, it's limited to list, board, and calendar. And calendar is a relatively new feature that Todoist released. And unfortunately, it's only for paid customers, but I think that this is a really great step forward for Todoist so that it's a little bit more versatile than strictly list and board views. And the other things you can do here are groupings, sortings, date, deadline, priority, label. So in that sense, there is a bit less customization here that you can do in the way that things look, the way that things are organized. But at the same time, that means that it's more pre-made and ready to use. So that is a positive element of it being a little bit more structured than in Notion. Next, let's talk about really important task management properties like recurring, dates, deadlines, and more. So with Todoist, it's really nice how built out this is in terms of what you can add to it. For example, my water the plants task, it is a recurring task here every Sunday. I can easily add that in. If you have a paid plan, you can add a deadline. So this is really great for tasks that you know that you have to do it by a certain date, but then you might also want an actual date. So for example, if I added a task called essay due, then I could add a deadline here, which is the actual deadline where I need to submit this by. But then I can also add date that I'm going to actually do this task. This really adds flexibility in terms of having hard deadlines versus the dates when you actually plan to do it. A few other things that are super useful is that you can immediately add reminders here. This is really nice that you can even schedule it before the task like this, and you can even add location so that it reminds you at a certain location. Priority levels are already pre-built like this as well. Todoist has a lot of features for task management that are already pre-built and really easy to use. If you need more things like labels, you can add that in here. On the other hand, with Notion, if you want to add priority levels, you have to create these yourself. So that means that you can get more options than in Todoist. For example, you might have a low, medium priority or super high priority. It's really up to you what kind of levels you set here. You can even remove this priority completely so you don't even see it. The other thing for Notion is that if you wanted to add two due dates for the hard deadline versus the date due, you can easily add that in as well. The properties are pretty much endless on what you can actually add here. So all of these you could add, which makes it really flexible. And for statuses, you can also make your own statuses here. But for example, compared to Todoist, if you want to add a simple reminder, you have to go through due date and then add a date and then click remind, and it shows you these options. There is a bit more options when it comes to Todoist with the reminder system, and it's also a lot more visible. The recurring is not a built-in feature that you can easily add to the due date. Instead, what you have to do is to either create a recurring task. So I can add a repeat to a certain task every week, every 2 weeks, and things like that. Or I can add a automation that's going to add a new task here. I can choose the frequency for this task to appear, but you do have to do a lot more tweaking in order to get it to really do a recurring system similar to Todoist, which could complicate it and be confusing for some people. Next, let's talk about notes and docs. With Notion, it's really easy to add any kind of text you want in here, and it's very free form. You can add templates for that as well. So if I go here, edit this, I can add even more. So I can add prompts here for tasks and so on. So I think that this is really nice that you can add all of these notes and docs. If you want, you can even add a page inside of here /page and even write out more things that you might need. So Notion is really built in a way that supports writing notes as well as task management. On the other hand, with Todoist, if I want to add more notes here, I'm limited to this description that I can add things. It's not really a fully fledged note-taking system here. I can also add comments to my task as well, but I can't just add a document to projects. It is a little bit limiting with Todoist to write full pages of information inside. Next, let's go over calendars. This is something that Todoist has really improved on. I think that this is a really cool feature. You can connect it to Google Calendar and see your entire day's schedule at the top while you're doing your daily task management. You can see your upcoming, and you can even plan out your schedule and when you're going to do certain tasks based on your calendar. So I can just move this in, which is really great for time blocking. It's a feature that I really like. On the other hand, with Notion, if you want to see your Notion projects, tasks, and all of these things alongside your Google Calendar, you do need a separate app called Notion Calendar just to do that. And that can be a bit limiting in the sense that you have to go to open in calendar and you can't do it straight from your Notion workspace. You do have the option to go to home where you can see a basic view of your upcoming events, but this basically just mirrors your Notion calendar and you can't just show this information anywhere in your workspace. You have to go to home in order to do this. So I do think that that is a bit limiting for Notion. The other thing is that if you want to see your tasks alongside your calendar, you do have to make it a task type database. And in that sense, you do have to change one of your databases into a task database where it's required to have an assignee and all of these things. So you can't just have a checkbox system. You do have to have a status, for example. So it's a little bit limiting if you want to have a universal inbox for your tasks compared to Todoist. So next, let's talk about subtasks in Notion and Todoist. This is an example in Notion of the Ultimate Project and Task Manager template. Here I have built in subtasks. As an example, to get subtasks, you either have to use a template which has a complex formula inside, or you can build it yourself. But by itself, it's not going to show something like this. You can either turn on a simple version, which is to go to customize tasks and then make sure that sub items are turned on. But even then, it's kind of basic in the sense of how you see these tasks, subtasks, compared to a traditional task management system. What you can do in Todoist is that it's already built in. So if I go to Todoist and let's say that watering the garden, I can add subtasks here and then add task. And then if I click out, you can really see the subtasks easily like this, already pre-built. You don't need to add any fancy formulas for that. So in that sense, Todoist is really great for subtasks and managing those. So the next thing I wanted to show is gamification. With Notion, if you want to add gamification to your task management, you do have to create it yourself. So this is a sample of the gamified task manager. There's also a tutorial on how to build this over on the channel, but basically it's a completely made from scratch, and you basically assign points when you complete tasks, and you can assign rewards for yourself, and the reward's going to be unlocked when you reach the 100% goal. You can also see your progress with charts, and you can have your task list here to actually do them. So I think it's kind of cool that with Notion, if you do want to add gamification, you can still do that, but it is something you have to create on your own. On the other hand, with Todoist, it's completely built in and included as part of the app. So if I want to see this, I can go here and then click here, and then I see my daily, weekly, and karma, and you can see your daily goal. You can edit this goal as well, like how many tasks you want to do every day, weekly, and goal celebrations, what days you have off. So gamification system built in to Todoist is really nice that it's already included. Next, let's talk about team use for Todoist versus Notion. In my opinion, Todoist is more limited with team use. It does now have this kind of team workspace where you can set up folders and you can see task lists by project. But compared to a lot of traditional project and task management apps, it is a little bit more limiting, as you basically have just folders and projects, and the lack of, for example, docs and other views like timeline view might make it a bit limiting. If you want to do very basic project management with Todoist, it's also possible. You can invite members to your team space, basically plan projects this way. But if you're looking for something a bit more, then this might be pretty limiting. On the other hand, if you're in Notion and you want to do project and task management as a team, it's a lot easier, and there's just so many new things you can add to it, like sprint planning, sprint boards, and tasks. You can add your own planning and review. For team use, Notion is really great. You can share and easily see share settings like this. So I would highly recommend Notion for team use and collaboration for those reasons. Finally, let's talk about the pricing for Todoist versus Notion. Todoist and Notion are both free to start. It is a little bit more limiting, in my opinion, with Todoist free plan, just because you can only have 5 personal projects, you have limited views, and you don't really have the calendar layout. At the same time, the pricing plan for paid plans in Todoist is extremely affordable. So it's only $4 per user per month. And after that, you can get 150 filter views, calendar layout, task duration, and the deadlines, which are really useful. So I do think that pricing wise, Todoist is very reasonable. On the other hand, with Notion, the free plan can allow you to do a lot. You can basically use all of the different views, the only limitation being that you only get one chart. If you want to upgrade to the plus plan, you get a lot of additional features like unlimited file uploads, custom websites, automations, but it is a bit more expensive compared to Todoist, and it also has business to enterprise. Todoist also has business plans, which are relatively affordable comparatively. So Notion is more expensive, but it does have a bit more features compared to Todoist, and it can really become a fully fledged project and task management system. As opposed to with Todoist, it's most useful for personal use with your family for small projects in smaller teams, but it is a lot more affordable. My final thoughts regarding Todoist versus Notion is that if you're looking for a solid task management app without any additional features or complex customizations, Todoist could be the simplest and easiest to use solution. If you're looking for more features like the ability to add notes, journaling, complex project management with a team, then Notion could be for you. Both are free to try, so be sure to check the links in the description. Thank you so much for watching. I hope that this was useful for you all. Let me know your thoughts about Todoist versus Notion, which is your go-to app. If you have any questions or comments, be sure to leave them below, and I hope to see you all in the next video.